Hey guys, this is Mike Tarala with Qlik, and this is part two of the Qlik Sense product tour for our cloud-based editions of Qlik Sense. In part one, we briefly introduced the main interface and showed how quickly we can create an app, add data, and visualizations. In part two, I will show you the various options that will allow you to manage your newly created content from the new hub interface. In the last video, we created a simple app, added some data, and created some visualizations. Now let's finish up this app by quickly adding a thumbnail so we could identify it in the hub. So I'll just expand the title, click on edit. I can change the title or add a description, or here I can change the thumbnail. What I'll do here is just upload a thumbnail from my workstation and then just add that and confirm. Okay, so we can now collapse this panel. And then we're going to go over to the app overview because I want to show you one important step. Right now, since we're in our own personal space and created content for ourselves, we have the ability to make this content available to others. And you also have the ability to control what sheets are seen within this app. So what we're going to do is take the sheet that we created, right-click, and select Make public. Now we can navigate to the hub, and there's our app ready to go. Okay, so the app I just created is ready along with other apps that have been either created or uploaded. As you can see, these are available under the Your Content section, and this is available when you are in the home page. Now, the home page basically is your main area to quickly access any of the apps and content that matter to you. And this includes content that is available in your personal space and apps that you have marked as favorites. And those apps are either from your own personal space or other spaces that you have access to. So you hear me using the word spaces, so let me briefly touch on those. Spaces are accessed via the Explore page, as you see here. And there are three types of spaces in the cloud-based editions of Qlik Sense. The first one being your personal space, basically for your own private unpublished content. And then there's shared spaces used for individual or group development or co-development and collaboration, basically just for app creation. And then there are managed spaces. And this is where your content is published or delivered to, so your users can access it. And no app creation takes place in any of the managed spaces. Now, the topic on spaces really deserves its own video, and I will be working on a few of those. So I'm not going to go into too much detail in this particular video. So understand that each space can be assigned users and have permissions and roles that control access and actions to it. Okay, so for the next part of this, let's talk about the home screen and the area marked as recent favorites. So now that I've also informed you a little bit about spaces, you'll notice that you'll have areas to store favorites. And these favorites can be content that you create or content from other spaces, as I mentioned earlier. So I can click Add Favorites, for example, and then what it'll do is basically bring me to the Explore page and show me all of the spaces and all of the apps in the spaces. Or I can, if I go back to the home page, I can navigate myself to the Explore page and then choose a space. I can search for a particular space, or just, for example, let's just take Bob's shared space. Bob has a test app in there, and I add that to my favorites. So now when I go to the home page, we can see that Bob's app is available in my recent favorites. If I wanted to take the product tour and add that to my favorites as well, it pops up there as well. Okay, so once again, just reiterating that the home page is for content that matters to you the most. Now, if you want to add favorites and organize them to what we call a collection, once an app is added as a favorite, you can then manage it within a collection. Now, we'll offer a little helpful button when you add an app to a favorite. A little button will come up that says Add to Collection. If you do that, It'll look for existing collections, or you need to create one. So we'll create a collection. We'll call it Mike's Retro Gaming Faves, and then click Create. And then it automatically adds that app to the collection. And I could check it or uncheck it, basically, to include or remove it from the collection. So here's another one. Let's add this to the collection. And now I'm going to add that app to the Retro Gaming Faves collection. Click Done. Now, obviously, they add the app to the recent favorites. But now if you want to see your collection, the best way to do that is go to your profile menu, click on Favorites, and now you'll see the collections. And then you can just go into the collection, and now you have your organized apps that you've added as your favorites inside the collection. Other ways of accessing the favorites, if you just click on these header links or title links, for example, it'll bring them in. And if you click the back button, it kind of brings you back to the collections as well. And then you can navigate between your content and your favorites as well. So there's a couple of ways to navigate favorites and add apps to collections. Okay, so in this section, we will talk about sharing. Now, when creating this product tour, I actually created a section of a video which I removed, but that section included sharing within managed spaces and shared spaces. However, it took almost 15 minutes to really get into all the detail on how it worked, so I decided to keep that as a separate video that I will link to in the description where this product tour is posted. Okay, so the last thing I'd like to cover in this tour is how you can locate and find apps. So when you're in the homepage, again, this is content that matters to you front and center. Explore allows you to navigate the different spaces that you have access to. Now, what I'm going to do here is edit this particular app that we created, and you'll notice that there's a spot for tags. Tags help you locate or help you find various apps. So here you'll see start typing a tag name, select an existing tag if it exists, or create a new tag by pressing enter or comma. So if I start typing sales, there is a tag already, so we select sales. Now I'm going to type Mike, and then I'm going to type Tarallo because we know that doesn't exist in there. Or I could actually put, for argument's sake, 1, 2, 3, and it adds new ones, etc. But let's just delete these last two tags, and let's just use these three. So now I signed these three tags to the Sales Dashboard 2019. Now note that this is in my personal section. I'm also going to save it into Mike's shared space, so those who have access to that can also find it. Okay, so now if I want to filter by tag, I want to look for all apps that have sales in it. And maybe I want to look for apps that also contain, for example, example. So I can select multiple tags and I can see any app that's been tagged with those keywords. And I could also clear the tags. I can search for apps by anyone, apps created just by me, and then apps owned by others, or apps that have been modified recently, or typical alphabetical. And then you can view the apps in the default view, which is the grid view or the list view. Now, list view provides a little bit more information. So that's it for the product tour for the cloud-based editions of Qlik Sense. I plan on making a few more videos that demonstrate some more of the content management features, so stay tuned. If you want a deeper dive on what is available with Qlik Sense and the other Qlik products, sign up and subscribe for our Qlik Insider webinar series, with the next one scheduled in November. If you want to be notified when more videos such as this are posted, and you're viewing from YouTube, click the bell icon below. And definitely, we want to hear from you, so tell me in the comments what you think. And don't forget to check out these other great resources to learn more about Qlik and Qlik Sense. And also, remember to join the conversation with myself and others in the Qlik community. Thanks for your time, guys. I hope to see you on the next video. Take care.